Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Angular, that is Angular version 17 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Angular project and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, please put a comment in your comment sessions. I'll try my best to help you. And also if you like this video, then please give it a like, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel and also to share with your friends. That will really help me to, you know, make more such videos. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install Angular, you'll need basically two software. So here if you see, first thing that you will need is Node.js, and then you will need Visual Studio Code. So for that you need to first simply go to favorite browser, and here you need to just simply search for it. Node.js download and hit enter, and here it will see this download button, the official site of Node.js, that is this nodejs.org. So just simply click on this download. I'll be putting this link in the description. So here if you see, we have these two options. One is LTS, another is current. So if you see current, the current version is version 21. We are not going to download the current version. We are going to download the LTS version. LTS version basically means long-term version. Okay. So this LTS version is what we need to download. So here if you see, the LTS version is Node.js version 20.9.0, and I'm going to download the Windows installer, the Windows MSI installer for version 64-bit. If you are using some other operating system like Mac OS, Linux, you know, or all these operating system, you need to proceed with this following link. I'm going to click on this, you know, 64-bit option, and it's going to subsequently start downloading our Node.js. Alright, so once you have that, another thing that you will need is a code editor, right? So for that, I'll be recommending you to use Visual Studio Code. So just simply type Visual Studio Code download, and there you have download Visual Studio Code. Okay, so again, this link I'm going to put right in our description, so you can use that link. So again, you can see we have it available for Windows, Linux and Mac. Depending upon what operating system you're using, you need to download that. So you need to download the 64-bit option. So click on that, and it's going to, you know, start downloading our Visual Studio as well. Okay, so let's minimize our browser, go to our download directory. So here we already have these two software, Node.js and Visual Studio Code. Let's install it one by one. So double click on the installer of Node. Click on next over here. Accept the license agreement. You can read this. Click on next. So this is where our Node.js is going to be installed. Totally fine. Click on next. So these are all they're going to install. Fine. Click on next. Now it is asking whether you need to install Chocolaty. I'll skip this. No need to install Chocolaty for our Angular. Just simply click on next and click on install. And it's going to start installing our Node.js. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And you will see it has rightly started installing our Node.js. So once our Node.js get installed, you'll be able to see this page. Node.js has been successfully installed. Click on finish. So now how we'll check whether Node.js is properly installed or not? Go to your search and just simply type over here cmd. It will show you this command prompt. Open the command prompt. And here if you just simply type node space dash dash version and simply hit enter, you'll be able to see that latest LTS version of Node, that is version 20.9.0, is rightly installed on our system. Okay, so if you see this similar type of message, then that basically means our Node is successfully installed on our system. So now it's time to install our Visual Studio Code. So just simply double click on the installer, and it will show you this license agreement. You can always read this, accept this license agreement, click on next. So this is where our Microsoft Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. You need to have 357.2 MB of free disk space there, right? So just simply click on next again. And I'd also like to create a desktop shortcut icon along with open with code options rightly available. Click on next, install, and it's, you know, preparing to install. And our installation has rightly started. And you can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Click on finish. So now that you know that you both Visual Studio Code and Node.js is rightly installed, also you can see that Visual Studio Code is opened. So along with the release note, I'll close this for now. Now it's time to install our Angular. So Here our command prompt is already open. So let's install our Angular globally. So for that, you need to just simply type npm space dash g. Dash g basically means globally you'll be installing Angular. So then @ Angular slash CLI and hit enter. And what it's going to do is it's going to fetch all the files. Okay, my bad. So I need to use the word install. Okay, yeah. So npm install dash g @ Angular slash CLI. Okay. So once you do that, it's going to fetch all the files from internet and it's going to install it locally on your system. So this dash g basically means we are installing it globally, not in any specific directory or anything. So it will be installed like similar to any other app that you have on your system. Okay, so that's what it basically means. And CLI basically means command line interface. Okay, so you need to have active internet connection as it is fetching all the files and it installing on your system. So it will take time. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. And there you go. You can see that our Angular is rightly installed. So you can just simply type ng space v and hit enter. V basically means version. This you can just n it. N basically means no. So here you can see that our latest version of Angular CLI version 17 is rightly installed on our system. Along with that, it is also showing that the node version is 20.9.0. So that is what I'm going to recommend you to install the node, not install the latest version of node. Always install the LTS version. So LTS version is the supported version for this Angular. So always install the LTS version as I have shown on this video. And you can see that our Angular is rightly installed on our system. Now it's time to create a new project. So for that, let's close this, create a new folder over here. I'm going to create a new folder called Angular Projects and open that folder, and I'm going to open command prompt over here. Just simply type cmd. So what it will do is it will open our command prompt right at this directory. All right, and now if I just simply type ng space new, and I'm going to give a project name as demo app. Okay, and simply hit enter. What it's going to do is it's going to start creating our project. So before that, it will ask you whether you'd like to use normal CSS, that is the traditional one, or you want to use all these different variant of CSS. I'll keep this CSS only. And whether you need server-side rendering, so for now I'll just simply give no, and it's going to start creating our project. Okay, so again it will fetch all the files from internet and all that, so you need to have active internet connection, and it will take time also to create our project. So once it gets created, I'll be again coming back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our project is rightly created. So it is showing one thing like Git is not recognized. So that is fine because we have not installed Git on this system. So that's fine. But the thing is, our project is successfully created. So if you close this, just simply go inside this demo app project, you can see all files and folders are rightly over here. All right. So let's go our directory back and open this project in our Visual Studio Code. So show more options and open with code. So this will open our entire project within our Visual Studio Code. And you can see it is rightly open. Yes, I trust the authors. So here are all the files. So if we expand this src folder, you'll be able to see we have this index.html. And if you expand this app, you'll be able to see our component, that is our app component.html. Along with that, we have a testing file. So this is our testing file. We'll not need if you are a beginner, okay, but this file you'll need, that is the component.ts file, and here is our config file, and here is our route file, all right, and here is our CSS file. So if you keep everything default, just simply go to these npm scripts and just simply click on this ng-serve, and what it is going to do is it's going to start building our project, and it's going to start our server and going to launch it our website on our browser. So you can see it has rightly started doing that. So I'll also like to talk about this file called package.json. So here if you see, we have this Angular version animation, that is version 17, then common, and all the things are in latest version, and all other different dependencies like Jasmine, Karma, so those are all the testing files, so those versions are also listed over here. And here in script tag, whatever you are seeing, this ng, start, build, watch, test, all that is actually getting listed over here, this under npm scripts. So here if you see ng, start, build, watch, test, so whatever property you set under scripts will get listed over here. So I am just simply using this beautiful feature of Visual Studio Code, just simply a click of a button will build our project. Okay, so I clicked on start, so ng serve is successfully done. Here you can see, so now if you just simply go to this URL, just simply click on follow link, it's going to open it, our project on our browser. You can see that our demo app project that we have created is successfully launched, also showing the message like congratulations, your app is running. So if you want to explore about all the different docs, like you can learn more tutorials, open all that, and you can follow the official document of Angular, okay, all that. So they have created this new interface of Angular in version 17. All right, so let's go back to our code. I'll open our HTML. I'll just simply do Control A, delete everything, and I'll just simply give one h1 tag, and within h1 tag I'm going to just simply print hello world, and I'm going to just simply go to file and save. You can also do Control I'm just going to click on save. You can also do Control S. Okay, so automatically it's going to if your server is already up and running, it's going to automatically build it, and if you just simply go to browser, you can see it is properly rendered the new code, whatever you have written, right? So yeah, so that's how you create a new project on Angular, and I have also shown you how to install Node.js and Visual Studio Code, all that. So that's basically all about this video. If you need more videos on Angular, please put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to make more tutorials on Angular and also talk about all the latest features that Angular version 17 is going to provide you. All right, so please put a comment in your comment sections, like whether you have really enjoyed this video and you need more tutorials on Angular. All right, so that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe, that will really help me to make more such videos. And I have also started one vlogging channel, so if you are interested, that link also will be in the description. You can go to that YouTube channel and you can like and you can subscribe also. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.